Good morning. Welcome to morning worship here at Rising Star Baptist Church. I am Bob Dabney, and I will be reading from the book of Matthew, first chapter, Matthew 18. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise, when as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with the child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, and was not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privately. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not, take unto thee Mary, thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken. Which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife. And he knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and his name is called Jesus. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you. We thank you for deciding before the world foundation was ever laid. You decided to send your only begotten Son to this world to save your people. We, your people. We, your people who had no way to save ourselves. We had no way to be clean. We had no way to satisfy you, Lord. So you decided that you would send your only begotten Son. Emmanuel, God with us. Jesus is God with us. You came and you sacrificed yourself for us, Lord, that we would be clean, that we would be whole, that sinners would have a way to make it into heaven, that you would be satisfied with us, Lord. Your righteousness is what cleans any man. And all the only way we can appropriate it is through believing upon you, accepting you as our Lord and our Savior. Lord, you made a way. Because the scripture says that no sinner, no backbiter, no murderer, no adulterer, no fornicator, no homosexual can enter into heaven. But you made a way, Lord. You sent your only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him shall be saved. And that's why we bow down before you, Lord. We praise your name. We shout it from the mountaintops. Jesus Christ, our Lord, is Savior forever. For whosoever will believe him and trust him. Lord, we have a debt of love. We owe you. We owe you, Lord, for what you've done for us. And not just us, but for all humans from every generation, from the generations past to the future generations, you have given yourself for us. We are regenerated. We are renewed. We have been born again by your Spirit and by your word, Lord. And we just thank you. We thank you for all you do. And you're still doing for us, Lord. We thank you for the vaccine that has finally come. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for all those that are recovering. We thank you, Lord. Thank you for being here in the midst of us as we go through. The sickness and death has been overwhelming, Lord, but you have been right here with us. You keep us, and you keep us looking up to you, knowing that you are God and nothing is too hard for you. Lord, we just say thank you for all the wonderful blessings that we receive in Jesus' name. Amen.